People throughout the Western Great Plains depend on the Ogallala Aquifer for their water. However, as aquifer levels decline, many towns and communities are searching for solutions to continue providing abundant, clean water for future generations.
Water is very valuable, most valuable product on earth. You know, you lose your water, you have nothing.
The water keeps our local economy going, our feedlot and our hog facilities. We lose them, you know, then we'll lose maybe our hospitals and schools.
If we don't have a robust economy, then we don't have our kids coming back, our population shrinks. Everything revolves around water. Well, without water, you don't have a community.
And so to be able to recharge the aquifer is a big deal to us, because that just produces sustainability and longevity, not only for us, but the next generation and the next after that, too.
Whether it's agriculture or civic or municipalities, everybody's feeling the effects of the aquifer dropping it.
In fact, there are already areas of the Ogallala where it's become too difficult to pump water. The water levels have decreased to the point where there isn't that much water left in the aquifer, and it's too expensive to pump it out.
We want to figure out ways to stay in this area. We don't want to be looking for, let's move to another state where there is water.
We're talking about a regional issue, and we need to recharge the aquifer all around us, because frankly, our wells are all around us. You know, we need everyone working together on this. We need landowners, we need the county, we need the city, everyone working together.
The Tomorrow's Water model helps communities explore ways to provide future water by reducing the impacts from aquifer overuse and increasing groundwater recharge through playas.
The purpose of the Municipal Water Initiative is to try to help sustain the water supply for communities where the Ogallala Aquifer is running low and projected to be out of water in 50 to 70 years.
Because as we think about the different tactics we're using to address our water concerns, most of them are about lessening the burden on the aquifer, right? But the Playa Lakes, on the other hand, is an opportunity to actually recharge that aquifer and recharge that resource. It's just an important piece to the overall strategy.
Tomorrow's Water is an adaptive, collaborative process in which local communities work with conservation partners to create an actionable plan to stabilize their water supply, with a focus on incorporating playa conservation as part of broader water quantity and quality efforts.
Playas have a very unique function when it comes to the Ogallala Aquifer. They are the flood control structures for the high plains. The water that collects in those playas, some of that water does percolate down into the Ogallala or the High Plains Aquifer. Especially in the southern part of the playa range, playas are the only recharge areas for the Ogallala Aquifer.
Because playas are a primary source of groundwater recharge, they are an important part of a water management plan. Once water use has been reduced, healthy playas can provide future water to support towns and rain-fed operations.
Healthy playas have a few basic characteristics. One, the basin doesn't have pits or modifications in it. It doesn't have sediment in it. And then the playa itself is surrounded by a good vegetative buffer, usually grass. What's important for people to realize is that they do recharge at a rate that is beneficial to municipalities, the family farm, and anybody living on the landscape in a sustainable way.
Recharge rates in playas are 10 to 1,000 times higher than under upland areas. While individual playa rates vary, the average recharge rate across the region is about 3 inches per year.
If you take that and put it on a 4-acre playa, that's 3 inches of recharge across 4 acres. That's essentially 1 acre foot of water when the playa is wet. And 1 acre foot of water is about 326,000 gallons. That's enough water to provide a family of four a source of clean drinking water for a couple of years.
In addition, water reaching the aquifer through playas is of higher quality because they act as water filtration systems by keeping contaminants out of the groundwater.
It used to be that we looked at wetland services primarily from a wildlife standpoint, but now we look at it from a clean water standpoint. They not only help with the quantity of water, but they help with the quality of water making it to the aquifer.
As water makes it to the playa, water then gets to infiltrate through the soil beneath it. And so the soil acts as a natural filter for materials that might be in the water that made it to the playa. On the way to the playa, the vegetation that surrounds the playa has a chance also to filter materials before they get to the playa itself. And that can be especially important if you've had that situation where the playa has been dry for a while and those cracks are big. If the water just comes from the cultivated or land around it, it might carry with it any residues of any chemicals that might have been used on that property.
Over time, many playas have been modified and are no longer functioning as healthy playas.
The number one threat to playas is filling in through sedimentation. And what that is eroded material moving from the upland surrounding playas into the playas and accumulating at a rate quicker than can be blown out of those playas.
You can see that three sides of this playa, the north, the west, and the south sides of this playa are protected with a buffer. Whereas on the east side, you can see it's not protected. It's a cultivated field. The sediment's coming in and forming a delta of soil on the edge of that playa with not a lot of growth. Every time it rains in the upland or snows, whatever it is, and that runoff comes, it's going to erode down into the lowest spot in the landscape. And the lowest spot in any high plains landscape is most likely going to be a playa. It will fill with sediment and the ground will become more level with the upland, and you'll just have buried hydric soils here, and the wetland will lose its function just slowly and slowly and slowly. But that clay layer exists underneath a playa. When a playa is restored, it can bounce back very quickly.
Playa restoration is an important component of the Tomorrow's Water model. In order to provide clean water for future generations, playas need to be healthy, with an intact basin, a protective grass buffer, and no excess sediment.
In the late 90s, this site was a crop field behind us, and it's hard to imagine. You see all the waterfowl out there and the wetland, the water standing, the wetland plants. But this had a couple of huge drainage pits in and had been land leveled. We came in with a contractor. We used engineers to design the project, soil scientists to help us determine where the fill and the sediment was, and scraped that material out, filled the deep pits, and then took the rest of the material, rebuilt the road. So we worked with the county road department here, so they were happy. They ended up with a better road, and then we took the rest of the material and put it on the hillside over here, and then planted this back to high-quality native prairie.
Although playas are a primary source of recharge, irrigation greatly exceeds recharge from playas. So the Tomorrow's Water model also includes strategies for reducing aquifer overuse and managing runoff within playa watersheds.
Playas are just one aspect of it. Maybe cutting back on irrigation or retiring some of these irrigation wells so we have sustainable water for these communities, I think, is a big factor.
One of the things we see in the southern high plains of Texas is as people run out of water, they use less irrigation water. They irrigate fewer acres, they change their cropping, they make decisions to, instead of going for cotton, they might go after some more specialty crop, might head toward grapes for wine or other things for other purposes. So there is a chance for them to adjust the way they use their water in their land.
There are some really innovative conservation strategies that people are working on. And in this part of the world, it's going to double with water conservation at the same time. Working to be more efficient with water use and using less water, whether it's, you know, for whatever crop that they're trying to produce. So some people, it feels like, are going to be probably transitioning out of row crop into perhaps more livestock operations, getting reestablishing grass. And so depending on markets and how that rainfall patterns and irrigation success in the future, some of that may really switch pretty quickly to a non-row crop, more of a grass production and grazing operation, which might mimic more historical patterns of land use in this part of the world.
When nearby irrigation is reduced or turned off, some communities have found that water levels in the aquifer rebound.
I got one friend, I'll give you an example. His family quit irrigating their farm about 20 years ago. There's like 6 playas around the property. And the wells, according to him, over a 20-year period, the water levels come up 10 foot in their wells.
One landowner said it best when he said, if we can get to sustainable with irrigation, then your playas become very, very important. And he was right about that.
For example, in this Texas town, if all the playas within 2 miles of municipal wells were restored, the potential recharge through those playas is enough to provide future drinking water for 63% of the population.
Long-term economic viability for many agricultural operations on the Southern High Plains is going to depend on playas and having healthy functioning playas.
We want it to use the water as best as we possibly can because it's our most valuable resource in this area. And we need to do everything we can as a community. And so it's going to take the surrounding areas and not just the city.
These playa lakes do contribute to Ogallala recharge, and especially around some of these communities, they're wondering, like, where are we going to get water 100 years from now? And these things could seriously play a role in solving that problem.
My advice to other cities and towns and other mayors would be have a plan, work that plan, but keep an open mind and be ready to implement new ideas that come along, such as leveraging playa lakes as a way to recharge the aquifer.
By using the Tomorrow's Water model, communities can develop a plan that includes reducing aquifer overuse, restoring playas, and managing runoff within playa watersheds. For more information about Tomorrow's Water and how playas can be part of your community's water management plan, contact Playa Lakes Joint Venture. We can help guide communities through the process of scoping the situation, developing a plan, and implementing a solution.